Hello students, welcome to the last series of uniform designing. In this particular session, we are going to understand what procedure for issuing and exchanging of uniform is followed in the hotels. In the last session, we have understood about uniform room in terms of its features and layout. We have seen the different areas positioning inside a uniform room, and we have also seen some of the design features of this particular room. After this session, the learner will be able to understand the procedure of issuing and exchanging of staff uniform in a hotel. He will understand the process, how it is taken from the employees and how it is handed back again to the employees in the hotels. First, we are going to discuss the issuing procedure of uniforms. Issuing uniforms to a new employee of the hotel. After all the formalities which is done with the HR department, the uniform is issued against a uniform request, or which is called as a uniform issue slip. This is the kind of authorization which is signed by the HOD, head of the department. This says that the HOD has given the approval for issuing the uniform, particular set of uniforms to this particular employee in the hotel. This form contains all the details of the employee, including the designation of that particular department. This makes easy for the uniform room to issue the uniform set accordingly. The uniform is then issued against the name of this new employee, and the entry is made in the uniform register, plus the signatures of the employee is taken for reference and the approval. This is a sample uniform issue slip format in which the details of the employee, the number of items which is being issued, and the quantity is mentioned in this. This is a second sample for the uniform issue slip, in which contains the name of the employee, token number if any given, date on which we are issuing the set of uniforms, his or her date of joining department, the designations, number of sets that we are providing, and the date on which it is being issued to that particular employee. This slip has to be signed by the employee who is receiving, with the acknowledgement that he will return back all the uniform sets if he or she is leaving the hotel. This is a sample format of the uniform register. Once the slip is completed and the uniform has been handed over to the employee, this separate information is being jotted down in the uniform register. It has the employee name, department which he or she has joined, date of receiving, means on which date the uniform has been issued to this employee. Then the details of the uniform, numbers, and the parts which has been handed over to the employee, plus the signature is taken for the same, and this record is maintained for all the employees, all the departments in the hotel. Now we are going to understand the uniform exchange procedure. By this uniform exchange procedure, we mean that how the uniforms are being exchanged between the staff and the uniform room attendant once it has been given for cleaning. The very first, or you can say the golden rule for this, is a clean for a dirty, or it is given or exchanged on one-to-one basis, which means one fresh uniform for a soiled one. So if a staff is giving a soiled shirt, in exchange that staff will be giving a fresh shirt only. We are not going to give him the complete set of shirt and the trouser, as he has only deposited a soiled shirt only. So this golden rule says, one soiled, for one soiled you have to issue, or you have to give, hand over only the one fresh clean part of the uniform. Once the uniform attendant, the person who is doing this exchange or who is responsible for the smooth exchanging or handing over of the uniform has to make sure that the uniform is spick and span and it is not damaged or do not require any repair work. If there is any damage which is beyond the repair, he or she has to inform the HOD or the executive housekeeper of the department. Always make sure that you issue a fresh uniform strictly on one-to-one basis. This makes the task easy to monitor also. The next step or the second step option is uniform slip exchange method. In this method, for example, if the staff has deposited the soiled uniform today, but by any reasons the clean uniform will be handed over to him on the very next day, in this scenario, a uniform slip exchange method is followed. The person or the employer deposits the uniform in the uniform room. He is being given a small uniform exchange slip with all the details. For example, on which date he has deposited, the name of the employee, department, time at which he is depositing this soiled uniform to the uniform room. Next day, what he has to do, he has to show the slip to the uniform attendant and the complete set along with the details which is mentioned on this slip, fresh uniform will be handed over to the employer. It is this copy, it is made in two duplicate copies. One copy is given to the employer and one copy is kept in that book for the future records. This is the sample for uniform exchange slip. This is a small slip which has the serial number, date, a token number which will be given, what shift and which department that employee belongs to. Then you have which article this employee has deposited. If it's a shirt, it's a trouser, blazer, it is skirt, apron, or whether it is a shirt or tie. Similarly, the entry will be made. This slip has to be signed by the linen and the uniform room supervisor and by the employee. This means that both are agreeing on the entry which is being made on this exchange slip. The next day when the employee comes, he only has to show this slip to the uniform attendant and as per the details mentioned, he will be handed over the clean, fresh uniform for the shift. For this session, this was all. Thank you so much. Have a good day. You can give your feedback in the comment sections and if you have any queries, please be in touch. Thank you so much.